Sunday, July 29th, 2012, 18 venturers embarked on a new adventure in scouting, VentureQuest 2012. With three advisors, they came to develop expertise in one of four majors they selected. Under the direction of Program Director Eric Walker, the fun started at check-in. Of immediate importance was finding out where to put one's stuff. Cabin assignments were handed out, then to see Doc Dornick to turn in the correct physical. Once in the cabin, it was game time to get to know each other. On the first day, VentureQuest was honored by a visit from Area 5 Venturing President, Michelle Legg. With everyone checked in, it was pool party time and swim checks. Then it was playtime. Water football seemed to be the attraction. After an hour and a half, it was time for the opening dinner. Thanks to Rod Counts, a great meal was ready. Here, participants got to know each other in the activity area and their staff. Eric gave everyone a rundown of the week and introductions. As always, eating was the most important part. Since everyone attended to develop new skills, little time was wasted. Once dinner was over, each area went their separate way to start training. Following 2 hours of intense training, the day ended with a root beer kegger and special games. Then, off to quarters for the night. Sunday evening, the climbers tested their skills on the climbing wall of the Geiger Tower. Once they mastered the climb, their next challenge was repelling the 55-foot wall. They were even challenged to climb the interior of the tower, then rappel down. Searching for something to say. They spent the day conquering obstacles that are 55 feet deep. After completing the Geiger course, they had become a team, ready for their next challenge. Sunday evening was a time of instruction, while Monday started off with a bang. Thanks to Marvin Atkins, each kid zeroed in on their target with 22, 9mm, and muzzleloader firearms. After the smoke had cleared, it was time to pick up the rod and reels. They learned to create their own flies. Should I try to do some more? Another skill they developed was using a fly rod, which took much practice. Wilderness First Aid is a Red Cross program that consisted of bookwork and hands-on practice. Ended with a test. Scuba diving began on Sunday with intense instruction in the classroom and in the pool. All lunches were trail style and sent with each area. However, there was one cooked meal each day prepared under the direction of our awesome quartermaster, Steve Lipke. After lunch on Tuesday, it was off to C&J Sports on Beaver Lake between Rogers and Eureka Springs, Arkansas. One stop for fuel in Nevada, Missouri, both for vehicles and people, then off again. C&J gave us the run of the bunkhouse and a great place to set up our kitchen area. Quarters were a little tight with four girls in one room, six adult males in one, six male youth in another. Everyone got to share except Margaret. Even so, it worked out and the air conditioning was great. Climbers got up early for a two-hour trip to beautiful Camp Ward. They started on Wednesday. They got to experience real rock cliffs. Rappelling took on a whole new meaning with their first 65-foot rappel on live rock. Thursday was the big challenge of the 270-foot cliff. Each got the privilege of testing their courage as they rappelled under the watchful eyes of the Camp Ward staff.
Once you start the 125-foot free rappel, it's like amazing because you see all the rock formations around and then you see the scenery that's off the side of the mountain, and it blows your mind that stuff can look like that.
With rods and their own flies, the fishermen challenged the trout on the White River. They also experienced being run off the river when the dam opened. Advantage of the wilderness behind C&J for practical application of wilderness first aid. Thursday, the first aiders had time for some recreational fishing. A catfish was caught, which they cooked on shore.
Life under the sea is better than anything.
Dive instructor Chuck McIntosh took the scuba divers on their first open water dive.
Somebody else's lake. You dream about going up there, but that is a big mistake. Just look at the world around you, right here on the ocean floor.
Over the 2 days, they completed four dives. They discovered a sunken Mazda and Volkswagen, among other things.
It's kind of neat to know that I can go in the water, breathe, and just swim around to see the environment that hasn't really been explored that much. The greatest thing about it was probably seeing all the fish and seeing what colors and everything that was put down there.
Thursday night, an intense water balloon war was raged. Wednesday night, we had some great beef stew, French bread, and pudding. It was a great meal. The fishing crew did most of the prep once Steve had the meat ready. That was followed up on Thursday with smoked roast beef with all the great sides, thanks to Steve and our scuba divers. Not only did we have a great evening meal, but more. The plan was to do some lake fishing Thursday evening. However, they were run off the lake by lightning. Friday morning, it was time to pack up and hit the road for camp. Another stop in Nevada for lunch and fuel, then to St. Joseph. After unpacking, it was a closing dinner prepared by Rod Couts and recognition and home. We are well on our way to the second awesome event, Venture Quest 2013, July 28th, next summer.